the spiritual father. See, look at the last one he said. And the creditors is come to take unto him my two sons to be bondmen. Why? Because the season of overflow. You see, even in death, Jesus is Lord. This man has died. And because of his faithfulness towards God, God activated his word. Season of overflow. God shall activate your season of overflow tonight. In the name of Jesus. Rather, this morning, we are already in 29. He's causing you overflow. Church, hear this. I will not be surprised if I come back home from Malaysia and I'll buy a house of 450,000 and pay cash. I can't be surprised. You know why? Because I'm only asking God for seven souls to transform their life, change their life forever. Seven souls. I'm asking God, do seven. I don't want to ask much. I want when I step into Malaysia and come out, I will have seven souls that will concentrate on you, that will trust in you to pay the price and be a city changer that will change Malaysia. That because of these seven people, the Lord of Malaysia will favor my people.
Amen.
Seven. And you know what the Bible says for only one? It says there is joy in heaven over one soul. And I'm asking for seven. What if God does it for me? He said in John chapter 15, verse 16, he said, because you have not chosen me. You have not chosen me. I have the one that chose you. And I have called you to go to the world, go to Malaysia. And bear fruit. And let your fruit remain. Ask me anything. I'm only, what is house of? He said, I will give it to you. I want to buy a house because we have tested the best places of Adelaide. We lived in Brighton at the beach. I'm buying a house there. Amen. And that's why when we came all the way to Devon Park, Elizabeth, I told my wife, it's time because she will not start. When a man is still falling into a pit, you can't start climbing up when you are still falling. It's only when you get to the down of the pit, where is that the end? Then you start thinking of how to come out. Elizabeth was the end of the pit. And we are now climbing up from Elizabeth to Smithfield, from Smithfield to Parahee, from Parahee to Mount Sinai. The next step we are going to take is going to be at the beach of the south. Offered it, and I'm paying 100% because I'm the Bible that people are reading. If my God cannot do it, if my faithfulness cannot do it, if do you know how many people that came to us when we landed in Australia? Nigerians, they say we are powerful born again Christians in Nigeria. But when we came here now, you see us, we can, in fact, drinking 12 bottles of a beer in a week is small. We never drank it. We were members of Asia. Church, I'm telling you, on the last day you see it, they knelt down and said, Pastor Joseph, we see your fire is unquenchable. Don't allow this Australia to quench your fire. Let's see if through this your fire, you will be able to bring us back to God. We are hungry to go back. When we were in Nigeria, we were hot. But what has happened to us is what we don't know. If you lose your fire, it means we might not have any other hope. That is why I keep on telling you, no one gets born again. If there is no born again Christian, they are seen. I am the Bible, the word of God sent to Australia to deliver me. And he sent forth his word. He got. I'm preaching your word. You are still the God of miracle. You are still the God of miracle that did it for this woman and her family. If you are still the same, I'm tired of showing them what is in the Bible. I want them to watch on the CNN. I want them to watch on ABC News. I want them to
to invite me to the drums and say, Pastor Joseph, how is it that you said you were going to buy a house of 500,000 before you left for Malaysia, and now you are back because you preached the gospel? How did it happen? I say, it's God. The same God that gave me connection in Malaysia for Malaysia to be buying Nigerian oil is still alive. Do you know how God has connection? Malaysian government. They say we want to buy oil from Nigeria. That was when Obasanjo was there. And when I prayed about it, you know what God told me? I didn't call you to do business. I called you to preach my gospel. Paul says, I counted everything lost for the sake of the gospel. And if the devil tempted me with oil block to be supplying Malaysia with oil block, when Obasanjo, they say, we just need you to go with this letter to Obasanjo. Tell Obasanjo we sent you. Tell Obasanjo, immediately he sees the signature, Obasanjo cannot reject it. He gave me a hotel when we were doing the meeting. Istana Hotel, go and check it in Malaysia. It was only me, but it was suit. That when in the hotel we are staying in Malaysia, the price is 3 times Istana. I said, no, God, how can let me pay Istana so that my wife will see where Malaysian government have meeting with me. And that time I asked God, God said, did I didn't call you for business? I called you to transform life. What of if that is true? What of if God has said, I've seen your faithfulness? And you know God cannot now say, that Bishop Wesley Hostel, when they gave him a house, 1.something million in America, and God said, if you don't leave America now and go back to Africa, he said, as he was in the plane, God said, do you see that house you rejected? He said, if you go and do my work in Africa, I will give you a house better than that. And the more. I rejected my Malaysian offer. I gave it to somebody. I'm from the media. The person I gave it to went to Nigeria and entered into politics. He wasn't qualified. If you are not strong enough and you want to, you will kill him. The guy entered and they killed him. He's dead. That connection killed him. It was too much because he went back to Nigeria, changed every car, changed everything, money everywhere. Just go to Obasanjo. Only the money to fix things, to go to Obasanjo, they gave to him. He had not even seen Obasanjo, they killed him. He was planning on how to cruise and go and see Obasanjo with the letter they gave him. He was given to me. I called my elder brother. I said, you have anybody? I have an opportunity. But God said, if you do it, I will kill you. My other brother called his friend. And that guy messed up. They killed him, the family, everybody had left his boys, his children. And they did kill him with gun to show that he's an amateur in political game in Africa. They used only knife, chukum, 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 and killed him. Say you want to because you went to Malaysia and got money. I'm talking about real miracle. What of if as I'm going now to Malaysia and somebody, one of the tattoo, is having an attack or sickness. And say he came to our meeting. The Bible says, how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth with Holy Ghost and power. And he went up, and God heals him. He said, do you know what, when in your crusade, in your conference that I was here, what do you want? I said, I told God before I came, I want to buy a house at the beach in Australia. He said, how much is the house? I said, Malaysia money? Just $1 million, $1 million. He said, really? Look, I'll give you 1.24. It is done. Church, hear this thing. I'm only telling you your season of borrowing is over. You are now in your season of overflow. It can happen anyhow. God of miracle will give you miracle by all means. It doesn't matter how it's going to come. Open your heart. Settle your mind. For there is a miracle that is going to erupt and overflow in your life. Starting tonight.
Amen.
this night for granted. Overflowing, I'm excited. We just enjoyed our happiness. Now it's overflowing. I wouldn't want to keep you long. Let's get into the meeting. And Elisha said unto her, what shall I do for thee? Tell me. Church, don't forget. You have to be specific. Tell me. You have to tell her. If you don't tell her, don't expect anything. I have told God. I want after my trip. If I raise that 7 people that is going to change your screen, I want to buy my house at the beach. Specific. I'm specific. I'm telling God, man, Holy Ghost is here, powerful. And he has had it. And the Bible says, whatsoever your mouth speaks into my ears, as long as the Lord liveth, my hand shall perform it. Numbers 14:28. God cannot lie. He has never lied. And he will not start lying with me. He didn't lie to Abishai Pestilos. He won't lie to me. Are you getting it? I'm buying a house at the beach. That's where I want to buy. We tested it. I'm going back there. And because of me at the beach, there will be no overflowing of river.
Amen.
If I buy a house there, it's good for Adelaide. Adelaide will stop every overflowing because I cannot lose anything. The blessings of the Lord make it rich and can never add any sorrow to it. Does that make sense? Church, are you getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
Let's keep on going. And Elisha said unto her, what shall I do for thee? Be specific. Tell me what hast thou in thy house. Listen very well. And she said, thy handmaid have not anything in the house save a pot of oil. Have you ever read the Bible where God was saying, destroy everything in Revelation? Destroy everything in Revelation. Can you get it? 6:6. Revelation 6:6. Destroy everything in Revelation. But 2 things you should not touch. Shambalaba. Let me see if I'm right. Revelation 6:6. Yeah?
And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts saying, a measure of wheat for a penny, and 3 measures of barley for a penny. And see thou art not the oil and the wine.
2 things. Don't destroy oil and the wine. I mean wine and the oil. 2 things. Big revelation. Listen. Give me Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 8. Ecclesiastes 9, 8. Karabasham. Let me show you something. Let me show you what that oil means.
Let thy garments be always white.
Righteousness, faith. Have faith. Let your garment always be white. I don't want a spot. He said, 1 John chapter 1, verse 8. Yeah, go there, listen.
1 John. Again, the new commandment I write unto you, which thing is true in him.
That's
in him.
What's that?
1 John 2.
1 John 1, 8 and 9. Let's see.
Okay. If we say that we have no sin,
good,
we deceive ourselves. And the truth is not in us.
Mm-hmm.
If we confess our sins,
that's it.
He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins.
Now, when he forgives your sin, what happens? It's like a dot, a stain in your garment. It happened to Joshua the priest. Who can remember where it is?
Zechariah,
good. Chapter 1. It happened to Joshua the priest. So he said, go back to Ecclesiastes, let your garment always be white, which means if you confess your sin, if there is a spot in your garment, it shall be cleansed. Does that make sense? That's why he said, let your garment always be white. Don't allow any sin. Don't allow anything. I keep on telling you, a Christian might commit sin, but a Christian doesn't live in sin. What does that mean? When you confess your sin, your garment will become white. If there's any spot, the blood of Jesus will wash it.
Amen.
That's what he said here. If you can maintain your garment,
to the word.
Look at the next thing. I'm trying to explain all you, not all you.
It is as the king of Michigan. You've read only part A. Let your garment be white, which is the first thing. You have to make sure. Then the second thing is what?
What chapter, what verse
again? Ecclesiastes chapter 9, verse 8.
Let thy garments be always white.
Mm-hmm. Number two.
Let thy head lack no ointment.
Now, Elisha asked, what do you have in your house? He says, only oil. Do you know what that woman was saying? Do you know what it means, let not your head lack oil?
It's like someone like
beans, tinctures. I'm raising a generation that is going to be wiser than my children. That is going to be wiser than Archbishop Bessie, that is going to be wiser than Pastor Idika Kek Joseph. And that's my ultimate goal. The woman said, I have nothing except the proof that my husband never broke any rank. Except the proof that my husband did not break away. Except the proof that there was always a man of God, one man of God, pouring oil on his head. All I have is the oil you gave to my husband. All I have, Elisha, is the same oil. The transfer of anointing. Every morning you are late. Every month, Kaleba, Kashika. What do we do after our prayer and fasting? Is it not anointing of others? Is it Elisha? We have nothing. My husband was so faithful. He were his spiritual father. All we had was that oil. The same oil that was flowing. You see, it's like an oil upon the head of Aaron. So what was the woman saying? The woman did not only say that my husband was faithful. The woman was also proving that this man did not break away. This man was faithful. He was poor because he was not into gimmicks. He was not scanting around. You know how one of the Nigerian boys that served under me, he came to Australia and he came to me, he said, Holy Ghost told him. The worst part of it was he said it before you guys. He said, look at the picture, Holy Ghost said, go! He was scanting around. This man of God was not like that. He said he was poor. When he saw Omega Fire Ministry, he remained in Church of God Mission. When Omega Fire Ministry paid him money, where every other church you were calling him. He was poor because he doesn't want to jump from one place to another. He was poor because he was faithful. Is it not time to prove that this same God that allowed him to borrow can also cause an overflow? So I have nothing except the oil upon his head. Do you know what the woman went and brought? The woman went and brought his ordination certificate. The woman went and brought maybe when he was ordained, the ring that was given to him as a bishop. The woman went and brought an evidence that he had an oil. And Elisha said, now, that faithfulness, that oil is going to pay you. That oil is going to pay you. You will see that that oil in your house is the greatest achievement you have ever achieved. According to you, glory. You will write many books. Just prepare. You make money with books. You don't need anything. You just need my password on my Facebook. You just need my email. All my messages. I have more than 10,000 messages. People are making money with Tidahosa. Most of the books that are selling, best-selling in the world, those that they write it. Fire in His Bone was a white woman that wrote it. The ones they are using in the school, 1,000 Proverbs of Archbishop, is selling like no man business. His children gathered it. This, my father used to say this, they got 1,000. My thank God for Facebook is all the every year. All my daughter need every, just put my Facebook on. She will even, it also was 1,000 Proverbs of Archbishop. They are going to write 20,000 Proverbs of Pastor Idika Ken, and it will pay them in. They will use it They've not even started making money with most qualified to break away, but not the will of God. I'm going to write only two books. Most qualified to break away, and not the will of God. And also, my mistakes in life. These two books are the books I'm going to leave. My mistakes in life. So that people will see the mistakes I've made. And when they check themselves, I found out they've not even made the kind of mistakes I made in life. And yet, God proved himself faithful. They will now gather courage and begin to follow God. Because I learned it from Abraham. I learned it from David. I learned it from David and Paul. And Abishua. Say the oil. Then he said, Pastor, are you there? Yeah. Then he said, Bono D. The last Bono. Your husband has been borrowing. But this time around, you are going to borrow the last one. The Bono, the loan you took last, will be the last loan you will take in your life. The last money you borrowed to fulfill a project will be the last money you borrow in your life. If I be a man of God, let me tell you it's true. We are becoming debt-free. Immediately we finish paying everybody. The next thing is whatever we owe the bank. It's not much. It's less than 20,000. We just finish it. Throughout my life, and I will never go out there. Why? This is my season of overflow. It is me that has to work it out. God has told me this is my season of overflow. If you finish me